In this particular example, the business team implemented a third generation AI tool. It took about 90 days to do that in a proof of concept. And what they found was that while they had assumed over the last 2 years, they had done a really good job educating the marketplace in terms of the availability of the treatment and its clinical improvement, they found that actually wasn't the case, and that 22% of the relevant HCPs had no knowledge at all of the treatment. And part of that was because while they had thought they had done a great job of education and trying to understand why what they were seeing in practice was different, what they heard back was that, well, we don't really have KOLs, we have STLs. It's the same 12 leaders. We meet with the same 12 leaders all the time for everything, and they know all about us. And so that was really shaping their view of how wide they had spread the education. They also knew that their delivery mechanism was more complicated, and they were still working on some of the market access pieces. They knew both those things. But what they hadn't really understood is the relationship that if I can't get access to a drug easily, there's no reason for me to learn about it on the provider side. And so they weren't really appreciating the interrelationship between the difficulty and access and that lack of education. And then ultimately, what by solving this, they're able to put together broad education programs that drove hundreds of hours of savings, started to move that needle beyond that 22%. And most importantly, were able to show impact, which raised medical affairs profile within the organization in this case. So that's an example of a real world application of trying to make a difference in a strategy, using these sorts of tools, learning what needs to be done, then implementing actions and continuing to track those over time.